So the only videos or the only tapes left for Miller are mostly gameplay related things. I guess for completeness's sake, I'll listen to them. I was gonna skip the fundamentals of stealth, but I realize like these dressing for the mission ones seem kind of interesting. I'm just like looking for, little nuggets of Miller and Snake, so.
You probably heard this a million times, Snake, but you should always avoid combat with the enemy when possible.
Right.
We're outnumbered and in unfamiliar territory. We won't survive long in a straight fight, even with you on our side.
I know. Avoiding combat is rule number one in a sneaking mission.
That's right. Don't let the enemy know where you are, and attack only when necessary, using hit-and-run tactics to cripple them. It's the essence of guerrilla warfare. Can I ask you a favor, Snake?
If you ask nicely.
To make MSF bigger, we need to do some recruiting.
Yeah. What's your point?
I want you to avoid killing enemy soldiers as much as possible and send them back using Fulton recovery. Not much we can do with a corpse except give it a funeral.
Obviously.
Put him to sleep, knock him out, hold him up even. And if you do have to fight, try to leave them near death instead of dead.
And then use the Fulton recovery system. Sounds easy enough.
You know what'd be really nice, though? If we had a way to Fulton recover anybody at any time.
I remember when I first listened to that one. I was like, yeah, that'd be cool. And then I finally got the Fulton gun. By that point, though, I had so many guys, it wasn't really as useful as I hoped it would be. But I can kind of hear David Hayter getting a little... I saw someone mention a while ago they didn't really like his voice in this one. And in some of the cutscenes, yeah, he's a little... Sounds like he's stressing a little bit.
You can steal items from soldiers by putting them to sleep or knocking them out and then doing a body check. Get close to the unconscious soldier and press the action button when you see the icon. Or you can sneak up on them from behind and do a hold-up. It also works if the soldier's near death. Keep in mind, though, if you wait too long, you'll have a dead soldier instead of a dying one. And you can't do a body check if you're holding the Fulton recovery device either. So don't try.
I know I watched that one on tape. Some of these ones, I really wish I had watched or listened to them when I was actually like playing the game. Helpful info.
Don't carry any more gear than you need. If you try and stuff your entire arsenal into your backpack, it'll be too heavy and your mobility will be impaired. You'll only be hurting yourself.
I know. Take only what you need. Every rookie knows that.
You can check the weight of your gear before heading out. So make sure you do.
Got it.
I know.
Even a born warrior like you gets hand tremor, Snake. It happens even when you're full of stamina, and it only gets worse when you're tired, especially with larger, heavier weapons. Obviously, you'll get better aim crouching than you will standing. And when you use a scope, setting your sights on a single point will gradually give you a more precise aim. As we develop better weapons at Mother Base, though, you may gain access to new, low-tremor versions of the same guns. So if you expect the shakes to be a problem, you might want to put some resources into R&D.
I'll keep it in mind. Then again, the more you use a weapon, the more your hands get used to it. Sometimes it pays to be faithful to your gun.
So that's kind of like some nice info. Mostly stuff I figured out, but because it makes sense. Like low stamina affects your aim.
Choosing the right uniform is crucial. Pick one that matches the mission objective and your own combat style.
Short.
Jungle fatigues are made for jungle combat. They provide decent protection and let you carry a fair number of weapons. Your standard uniform, basically. The distinguishing factor is that your camo index will vary a lot, depending on the area. Wear a pattern that makes you blend in with your surroundings, and your camo index goes up. Wear something that clashes, and you'll stick out like a sore thumb.
Pick the right pattern for the occasion. Sigint used to lecture me on it all the time.
Sigint drop. All the time.
The sneaking suit is a specialized uniform for stealth missions. It provides excellent camo in any stage. Even better, you won't make a sound when you walk.
Mm. Ooh, so I won't need to tiptoe all the time.
And to top it off, it also makes your wounds heal faster. The fabric exerts just the right amount of pressure on your body to help stop bleeding.
Huh. Not a bad little trick.
Ooh, so I won't need to tiptoe all the time. See that? I didn't realize the sneaking suit made your footprints silent until a lot longer into the game. I think I actually read it, so it's like things like that that I wish I'd rather learn from the game than just hearing like a guide say, also make sure you wear a stealth suit so that you don't make any sound when you run. It's a really useful ability.
The battle dress uniform is the opposite of the sneaking suit, in that it's specialized for combat. It lets you carry plenty of weapons and ammo, and provides excellent protection. Not the best choice for sneaking, but if you feel like playing one-man army, this is the uniform of choice.
Looks pretty damn heavy.
It is. You won't be able to move as fast with it on, meaning it's not good for running away either. Keep that in mind.
Either. Keep that in mind. Also, the weight thing. I think it mentioned affecting your movement. Because, man, there's some missions where... I don't know if I went into them. You know, movement missions I was trying to run through fast or whatever, and I probably went into them wearing heavy stuff. Especially on Snake. Snake doesn't run the fastest as some of, like, your S and A rank soldiers have S rank running. So, that's one of the really negatives of the battle dress. I really, really don't like running slow, but... Defense. For boss fights.
Naked. That's exactly what you are with this uniform. The pants are the same as the jungle fatigues. Obviously, since you're exposing your bare skin, your defense and camo index are gonna be low. On the plus side, it's so light you can move around quicker.
Good for her. Showing off muscles, too.
Hey, Snake. I heard they gave you your old code name because you used to run around with your shirt off. Is that true?
Don't believe everything you hear. They called me Naked because I went in without gear or food. I had to procure everything on site.
You mean they sent you into the jungle without even a pair of pants? On a halo jump from 35,000 feet? Sweet Jesus, you are a legend.
You're busting my balls, aren't you, Kaz?
Little bit, yeah.
Hilarious.
Big Boss does not approve of being taunted. Oh, shit. But,
Choosing the...
Yeah, I guess that's enough for this one. Fundamentals of Stealth. I think I'm going to skip co-ops. Just because, I mean, it's a lot, and I don't really care. I might go back and do it later. I can fit these in here.
Snake. About
cardboard boxes.
It feels kind of weird me explaining this stuff to you, but there have been a few recent developments in cardboard box technology. So just to be safe, here goes.
Go on.
You can do much more with a box than just hide under it. You can put it someplace and leave it there.
Huh?
You can get on top of it and use it to reach high places, or hide from the enemy in its shadow.
I like what I'm hearing so far.
And that's not all. You can even put items in it and send them to co-op's teammates.
Really? I never thought of any of that. Damn. Is there anything a cardboard box can't do? Every soldier should have one.
Yeah, well, don't get too excited. This isn't exactly what they were made for.
Which reminds me, don't you think the boxes around here are a little on the big side?
You're right. I bet two people could fit under one box, if they packed in tight enough. They call them love boxes.
Love boxes.
Of course, you don't need a love box to fit two people inside. Any box of similar size will do.
Jeez. Oh, God. But yeah, man, I wish I I don't think any of the missions. See, I usually wouldn't listen to all the mission-relevant tapes, and I don't think these were any of the mission-relevant ones. I didn't figure out you could drop a box so that you could stand on top of it to reach high places until a really long time. I think I had to read it online. Disappointing.
Up to 2 people can fit inside a cardboard box.
Tell me how.
Move close to a box with a teammate inside, and an icon will appear. Then press the action button. You'll stay inside as long as the action button is pressed.
So, same as Snake Formation, huh?
Exactly the same. In fact, when you put on a cardboard box, when Snake in, both of you can climb inside.
Ah, a box big enough to hold me and my buddy.
Mm-hmm.
These are fine times we live in, hey, Kaz?
Yeah, sure, boss.
Sometimes they don't seem to really go together very well, these two. Tell me how.
Snake, the R&D team came up with something new.
What's this?
It's mm-hmm. a cardboard tank. It's got enough room for 2 people. Same as any other cardboard box. Apparently the guy in front drives, and the guy in back is the gunner.
Hold on, Kaz. Who the hell came up with this thing?
I'm sorry, boss. He meant well, I swear. I know it's nowhere as good as a real tank, but still...
It's brilliant!
Huh?
The perfect synthesis of stealth and attack power. Compact, elegant design, the finest example of a weapon I've ever seen. Seriously, Kaz, I need to meet the guy who made this. I want to shake his hand.
You serious? Snake, mm-hmm. look at it. It's
a masterpiece, in every sense of the word. You don't agree?
No, I...
What is that? A tank? I like it.
Puss?
I hate tanks, but this one I think I could get used to. I love that it's a zero-emissions vehicle. It will not hurt the forests of Costa Rica.
What?
Nice work, Kaz. I see I made the right choice making you second in command.
But I... Is there something wrong with me?
I like it. That, though I didn't quite like the delivery of that second in command line by Hader.
Snake, about that cassette player Galvez was carrying.
What about it?
That was no Russian imitation. It was the real deal. A prototype developed by a Japanese company.
Get out of here.
It's true. It had the Sony logo on it. The product name is Walkman.
Walkman.
It's a revolutionary new concept. Music you can listen to on the go. You can take it with you when you leave the house. I gave it a listen, and you wouldn't believe how good the sound quality is for something so tiny. And in stereo, too. Think of the technology that must have gone into it. And that tape is equally amazing. The treble range is clearly superior to any other cassette ever made. Stylish, too.
How'd Galvez get his hands on a model that's not even out yet?
Beats me. It's not the kind of thing I'd expect some stodgy Soviet to be into.
Me neither. Tell you what, though, it's a fine piece of work. It'll let me listen to my music when I want, where I want.
I never thought I'd hear you say that, but I have to agree. Me? I'm a recording freak, and I always used to laugh at the idea of a portable player. But now that I've seen it in action, I've changed my mind. Being able to take your music with you, this could be the start of a revolution in music.
Could be.
I'm having the guys at Mother Base study and analyze it. Who knows? They might be able to come up with something even better.
Miller's one of those guys. I didn't think it was possible, but now that I've used it, I mean, you know, at least it changed his mind. What was it? Stodgy Soviet. Okay, that's the end of this tape. Or video. Tape. Video cassette. It's a cassette.